This is the only bad thing about, about latex. Hello, everybody, this is QueenStatic here, and welcome to the month of October! Still not too much behind me. I'm gonna get there. For me, I'm still recording in September, but you guys don't know that. I have my box of tricks today down here. I'm going to show you guys how to do a zombie skin tutorial type thing. I'm going to start by doing it on my hand, just so that, you know, if you guys are a beginner, you guys can learn, because I think, for me, that's kind of easier to learn. And I'm also going to show you guys, if you guys don't have, like, Ben Nye makeup and all that, on what to use instead. Which some of those ideas I got from another great YouTuber. She's a special effects makeup artist. I love her videos. But I'm gonna show you guys what I use. So, I recommend getting makeup wedges, because with these, well, we're gonna be using liquid latex. And with the liquid latex, these are easy because you can just cut off the pieces that you've already used and stuff like that. This is the only bad thing about, about latex. That, and it smells like butt. If you think I'm exaggerating, I'm not. Oh my gosh. Do you guys hear this? How much this is going off? Jeezums. Okay, so you're gonna take some of the liquid latex, and I makeshifted my own little tray. You guys can buy, like, the paint palettes and everything like that. They work just as good. But, this is from, like, headphones and stuff like that. Back to my video now, since I'm so spastastic. You're gonna take some of the liquid latex. I'm hoping that this one isn't dried up, because then this would make, like... Ugh, it is clumpy. No! I'm going to take... Now, if you guys are allergic to latex, do not do this, because this is legit latex, and it will make you break out. There are other things that you can use besides latex if you're allergic, but you just want to apply first a thin, fairly thin coat of latex. If you apply it in thin layers, it's going to dry easier or quicker. You guys can see, and it feels very awkward when it starts to dry. Alright, so you let that dry. Okay, so after that one begins to dry, then you're going to just put another layer on top. You can see my pores on my hand. That's kind of funny. I mean, it doesn't have to be perfect when you're doing it. You can make it as big or little as you want. I'm gonna make it go onto my fingers, I think. Just my first four fingers. And then part of my thumb. This is clear latex. You can buy liquid latex that is flesh-colored. But the clear one is what I have on hand right now. As you guys can see, my hand is very, very shiny. That is the liquid latex. Okay, another coat on top. If you guys don't like the stickiness of the liquid latex, I suggest using powder. Really, any type of translucent powder will work. You can use tan powder. If you want more of a, like, a live skin look, I use baby powder because that's just what I have handy with a bulk of. But if you want to keep the stickiness at bay, which is going to happen when you start putting multiple layers of liquid latex on, as you guys can see, well, if I hold it back here, you guys could see it better, but the tips of my fingers are tan, and this part's white right here. That's fine. I'm just going to go over the rest of my fingers with the powder as well. Just to make it a little bit more white so it can blend in. Which it still doesn't. My skin is still red. And by the way, this is an old brush that I have. I don't suggest using new brushes unless you specifically bought them for this. Make sure you get in between your fingers. That's where the stickiness is really going to happen. And the nice thing about the powder is it just kind of sticks to the liquid latex, so you don't really need to worry about, you know, much else. So then we're going to put some more on. So we're looking alright right now. It's starting to peel up a little bit, which that's fine because we're going to peel some of it off anyway. Okay, so the next step we're going to do is we're going to take a paintbrush. It can be any size paintbrush you want. And we're just going to go and we're going to tear some parts of this. Make sure, I mean, you don't have to get the fingers, but you can. You know, the reason why I use the paintbrush is because of the effect that it gives. It gives a really neat effect, which I'll show you guys in a minute. If you guys can see it on camera, it made these cool little, like, ridges, which is kind of disgusting, but at the same time, it's neat. Put one here as well. Okay, so we have that part done. It's all this. So, some different colors. I'm going to take this color first. You guys might be wondering, why am I using lipstick? Lipstick acts like the cream special effects makeup. I don't suggest using your favorite lipstick on this because you're going to touch latex with it. So then what you're going to do is you're just going to go in and fill in the little gaps. So it's not quite dark enough, I don't think, but it'll still work. And you don't really have to be neat about this because dying, rotting flesh will never be neat. But you know, you just go in. You can go over top of the little other pieces of skin. Because blood is red, but it also has, you know, once it starts to dry out and everything, it gets darker and it gets more brown and disgusting. And that's what you want this to look like. You want this to look disgusting in every way possible. If I had black, I'd still put black on here too, but I don't have any black. This really took this long to record. Wow. So yeah, I definitely like the purple as a base first, rather than the red, but that's alright. And then if you want some, like, red and irritation, you don't have to clean the brush off. I mean, it'll add kind of a neat effect to it. But if you want some, like, red irritation just around, like, the edges where there's no, where there is no stuff, you know, you can do that. Which I'm just going to, like, totally just butchered that, but, you know, it looks more like I punched somebody, or somebody cut me, but. I'm gonna put some in the crease, and put some, just like on the upper part. Some of my fingers, and, you know, the lipstick won't hurt your skin, so you can put some around your nail beds, make your nails look reddish and swollen. I already have cuts on this hand, so. You guys can do less of these, which will make it look, I think, a little bit better. But, you know, I really enjoy doing it. Oh, no, as I go, I didn't get my thumb. Yes, I did. And, you know, I made my fingers look kind of reddish. And I think that it looks all right. I'm not the best at doing special effect makeup, but I figured just for fun I'd do some of it. So if it's not the greatest, you know, don't get mad at me. But I enjoy it. Alright, so that's my zombie-ish dead skin makeup tutorial for the month of Halloween! Ooh. I'm gonna do a video right after this showing you guys how I take off liquid latex. So stay tuned for that. And remember to follow me on all my social medias. They are listed in the description box below. And subscribe to my channel. Become a member of the Staticsphere. And remember to share a smile today. And I'll see you guys all next time.